is a very peaceful animal with a bad reputation. When you see a gator on TV, they're usually biting someone's arm off or doing something naughty, but 90% of an alligator's life, that's what they do. Okay? The other 10%, they may chase females, they eat food, the American dream. Okay? Now, I wouldn't get this close to a wild gator. It could run away and may even attack if it feels cornered. Alligators fear humans. They want nothing to do with you. Their main diet is small game, mostly fish. But they also eat turtles, birds, frogs, possum, raccoons, stuff like that. These gators here, I have three of them, two more in the water. They're used to doing shows. We don't wrestle these animals. We use them for education, so they're very comfortable around us. This is why I could get close to them, and they don't really care too much, okay? His name is Killer. He's the biggest one that I have here, okay? The only thing he's gonna kill is time. That's about it, all right? You can't train them. They're not, you know, like a dog. They're not gonna love you like your dog or a circus animal or anything like that. But they do respond, and they do, guys, if you want, come in, come in. Come on in.
You're intimidated by the no entry signs.
Oh, okay. What's up, Killer? How you doing, buddy? Great. Oh. 80 teeth, 40 on top, 40 on the bottom. And like most crocodilians, and when I say crocodilians, I'm talking about alligators, crocodiles, and caiman. They have the strongest bite in the animal kingdom. Over 2,000 pounds per square inch of closing pressure. That means they bite stronger than a shark, a hippopotamus, hyena, pit bull. I don't care what you put them up against, these guys are on top of the list, and that is another reason why I am not sticking my head in his mouth, okay? Now they have a very big bite, but a very small brain, about the size of a walnut, located here. So they're not geniuses either, okay? Small brain. On the back of a gator, you're gonna notice these bones here. These bones are really important. They're called scutes. And the scutes have two main functions. The first one is pretty obvious. It's a body armor, protecting their organs from the top, but it's also a solar panel. They absorb sunlight for energy, so they can move around and metabolize their food. If you see an alligator out there basking in the sun, they're using these to basically recharge their batteries. They're cold-blooded, so they need sunlight. Now, they spend most of their time in the water, so for swimming, a powerful tail. All muscle. They put the arms and legs back and use the tail to propel themselves through the water. The tail is also used for fighting. It's a weapon. They'll swipe, you know, each other with it or, you know, a person. I've seen people get hit with a tail on the foot, on the leg. It leaves a really nasty red mark. It hurts a lot. If that were to hit you in the face, it could break your nose, break your teeth, break your facial bones. Really heavy and strong, okay? They can live anywhere from about 50 to maybe 70 years, so a pretty long time for an animal. And they can stay underwater for about an hour. If it's really cold outside, they can actually slow down their heart to 2 beats per minute, excuse me, enabling them to stay underwater for about 6 hours. But it's got to be really cold. Now, if you want to see a really cool video, I saw this on Facebook about a month or two ago. It's probably on YouTube. You'll see a frozen pond with the snout of an alligator sticking out, okay? So I don't know what state this was. The most northern state for an alligator is North Carolina. It's possibly it was there. But that would be a case where he would have to slow down his heartbeat to about a beat or two per minute, because if he stayed at his regular metabolism, he would have froze to death, okay? So that was a really cool, you could put frozen pond, alligator, and I'm sure you'll see it. It's pretty cool, okay? One of the questions people ask me, I get this one a lot, is what is the difference between an alligator and a crocodile? The Everglades is the only place on Earth where there are both gators and crocs, okay? On your boat ride, you probably saw a few gators out there, but you most definitely didn't see any crocodiles. That's because the American crocodile is a coastal animal. They live closer to the coast, the southern coast of Florida, where the fresh and salt waters start meeting, so in brackish waters, okay? These guys are in fresh water, inland. You're gonna see gators out here on an airboat ride, okay, in the marsh. First thing you wanna look at is the face. Right? You look at Killer here. You notice they have a nice rounded snout, like the letter U. Crocodiles, a pointed snout like the letter V. Alligators have 80 teeth. Crocodiles only have about 60. Now, when you see a gator in the cartoons, what color are they usually? Yeah, they're green. Is this guy green? Alligators are black in real life. Crocodiles come in brown. They come in gray, green, black. Some have a lot of yellow on them. There are 14 species of crocodiles. They're going to come in more colors and sizes. There are only two alligators, the American, and can someone tell me the other one? There's only one other gator in the world. Give me a continent. Where? Amazon? No. Australia or crocodiles? Good guess. Crocodiles. You're running out of continents. There's only seven of them.
Thailand.
Okay, where? No, those are crocodiles. You said Thailand. What continent is Thailand in?
Asia.
All right, give me another Asian country. The most obvious Asian country. China, right? Don't overthink it. China is the only other place on Earth where there are gators. The Chinese alligator is about half this size, probably not even, and a little lighter than, and not as dark as the American, so just two gators. I'm going to go ahead and bring an alligator out to you so you can see one up close a little bit better. Don't worry, it's not going to be this guy here, okay? So give me a second. I'll be right back. Have a seat so I can walk around. I'll be right out.